Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So in the last video, we have checked how we can create an entity in SiteGround Content Hub using code, using web client SDK. In this video, we are going to check how we can delete an entity in Content Hub using web client SDK. So you can think of different scenarios where we want to delete an entity using web client SDK. Suppose you have a repository of assets and you have a connector which is actually pulling all the assets from that particular repository into your Content Hub, and in order to create everything into your Content Hub from that repository, you are again leveraging web client SDK to create those assets. Similarly, you can think of like if that repository, if there are certain assets which got deleted from that repository, and you also want to make sure that your repository is in sync with what you have in Content Hub, you want to delete those assets in Content Hub as well. So for those scenarios, you can use web client SDK to delete your entities there. So let's just get started. So what I'm going to do is, see, last time we have we created this create entity class to create an entity in Content Hub. This time we are going to call another class to delete an entity. So maybe let's just quickly create a duplicate of this and call it as delete entity. And why I'm calling it as an entity, because everything in Content Hub is an entity, right? So that's why I'm just using a normalized name for this one. Delete, let's just call this class as delete entity, and maybe let's just copy this here as well. And as we are going to delete an asset from Content Hub, I'm just calling this as delete asset entity. So that is one thing. We have our class in place now, and what now I can do is I can just get rid of everything from here, because this was specific to delete asset entity, which is okay, right? And I can also make this as void. This is also not required. Okay, now so in order to delete an entity in Content Hub, we need an ID. So we need an asset ID for that. So what we can do, let's just declare something, asset ID, and let's just have something in here. We'll just replace this later. And then once you have this one, we already have a client object created there. So we call it as mConnected. That's the class which we have created. Then it has client, which is of iWeb client. Then it has entities, right? And from entities, we can basically simply call as delete async, right? And if you see what parameters take, it takes an entity ID here, which is of long type. So let's just copy over this asset ID, which is nothing but our entity ID in this case. And we are done. Right now, let's just try to replace this asset ID with the actual asset ID what we have there. So let's just go to our Content Hub environment, click on assets, and from your assets, let's just take some simple assets. Maybe we can just take this asset only. So if you click on this asset, as you know that we can, we have different options to check the asset ID. One is directly on the URL you can check, like 31037 is an asset ID, and on the right hand side also on the system properties you can see we have this ID here created, ID 31037. So just copy over this ID and go back to your code, just replace it here, right? So we have this asset ID, and so right now we are able to access this page, which is good. And we replace this asset ID here, and we call this a delete async, which has an asset ID there. Right, so this is what we have. Now let's just call this one, and in order to call this, let's just go to program, and here we are calling this one create entity of m.asset type. That is what we have done last time. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to create delete entity of m.asset type. Definitely it is of asset type only, and let me just make it as delete entity dot delete asset entity. Okay, this cannot be void, so var asset ID. Okay. And then let's just go here, make this as task and where my asset, and we should be now good. And then let's just return my asset. Okay, so we are good here. And so we have the delete asset entity here. We call delete async. We pass the asset ID as a parameter, and from the calling function, we simply, let's just see. Okay, this is actually not required. Right. Okay, so let's just try it out now. Just build it. Let's see what we have here. Okay, so this seems to be done. And if we go back to our system here now, and if we try to refresh this one, let's just try to refresh it here. And right now we see this 404, and if I go back to my assets page, now I don't see my that sidecore asset also which I created before, right? So this is a very simple, you know, way how you can delete, control your control asset deletion directly from your web client SDK. And there could be, you know, different scenarios which you can consider for deleting, you know, this from code programmatically. So yeah, and based on your business needs and requirements, you can you know, just change it. And you can have some, you know, scheduler also which can inject there, and which basically takes an asset ID and then start deleting those things at a regular interval based on, you know, how, you know, what is your frequency, how you're pulling it and how you're deleting it. Basically it's all about your frequency and your sync operations there. So this is what you know, I just wanted to show how you can delete an asset, and I hope it was helpful. Just let me know if you have any questions around this one. Happy to share. And thanks guys, thanks for watching, and see you next time. Thank you.